Today is still of January 2019, and Happy New Year's to all listening in. Market today opened with a gap down, and after the initial hour move, it actually fizzled out. Eventually, it retraced and down 26 points to close at 3012 with above average volume. The immediate support is at this level, 3000. There was previous attempt over here. More significant support is at 2960. The immediate resistance is at 3080. This happened to coincide with this gap here, and there were two previous attempts to test this level but was not able to take it out. The small significant resistance is at 3130. Now, looking at the moving averages itself, it's quite evident market actually stuck in a trading range, so it's actually non-directional. So we just have to be careful as it's likely to be very choppy. Again, let's turn our attention to the obvious strong stocks. This is Best World. Now over here, after making a high followed by a series of sideways bar, there was an attempt to actually break out yesterday, and today we have actually a break above this high here of 275, but didn't close that well. Likely to pull back. During the pullback, we look for a setups to go long. Now, two of the REITs actually has performed well of late. This is Keppel KBS REIT, denominated in US dollar. Notice actually it was forming a basing patterns. Also notice that actually the contractions in range and the drop in volume, and this actually break up of these consolidations very nicely with increased volume. Look for pullback here, and we look for new setups. Go long. Manulife. Notice also very nice inbound trend. Look for pullback, and we look for a new setup to go long to actually take advantage of the strong inbound trend. This is Yang Zijiang. Notice actually the stock has been actually trading sideways tight range. So there was this attempt at this high here of 130. But it retraced. So right now we see the pullback. I'd like to actually see how it turns out. The fact that this stock has been trading very nicely, it is only reasonable to expect the stocks to actually consolidate before breaking on the upside. So we need some patience. Yingli. These are one of the very few property stocks that actually moved up. You notice actually we have a strong inbound trend here. Notice the increase in volume followed by a pullback. This is a big, deeper setup. 2-month callback high here is at 118. Now remember, this stock is trading below 20 cents. Let's take a look at the weak stocks. This is SPH. Notice a very directional move with throwbacks. And here we have a big, deeper breakdown. This is triggered today. So you've taken this trade, put a stop loss, one tick above this high here of 240. So if you have missed the trade, just look for true back and we look for new setups. Notice that it's 1326 in order and it's opening up very nicely. Singtel. Again, after this gap down, make successive low followed by a reaction here. This is a big deeper setup and actually broke yesterday. Today follow through, didn't close that well. In fact, form a doji. Again, if there's a throwback here, we can look for setups to shut the stops. City Dev. Notice after this throwback itself, stock actually break down yesterday and today follow through. You have missed the trade, look for throwback and look for setups to actually short the stocks. Just be mindful when you approach this level. UOL. Again, stocks were stuck in the trading range. They were an attempt to actually move up but actually failed with the wide range reversal bar and today follow through. Again, it is still too early to actually trade these stocks because if you look at 1326, it's actually part of a trading range. However, we would like to actually wait for it to complete this consolidation and break on the downside. Oil related stocks are also weak. This is Keppel Corp. Notice after the gap down, there was a very violent throwbacks. And over here, we have a big deeper setup. It actually broke today. Just be mindful with a trade like this, because usually this gap here provides some kind of support. So for the conservative, it's better for this low to be taken out and look for a new setup. Perhaps easier to manage trade will be Sembcorp Marine and Sembcorp Industry. Right, notice actually here the throwback itself, though there's a gap, but it's not that big. Here we have a big deeper setup, still bar count back low here. This is this level here of 152. Sembcorp Industry. Similarly, but here it was triggered right today. Again, taking a trade, put the stop loss one tick above the high here of 256. Now the banks remain actually stuck in the trading range. Take a look at DBS. DBS and UOB have quite similar patterns. You notice with very big swing. The last 2 weeks itself, actually, we have a series of sideway bar clustered together. So actually right now, it's not as we should leave the stocks alone until direction is very clear. Likewise for UOB. Alright, you notice actually approaching this support. I'd like to see how we actually react over here. A clear patterns will be OCBC. It's trying to form a base patterns. Alright, with the neckline here at this level here at about 1150 or so. So you notice actually again this is really a part of a consolidation patterns. If you break on the upside, this may well be a reversal patterns. But given the situation currently we are experiencing, market sentiments tend to be weak. Any break on the upside will likely to be limited. So again, essentially looking at the raw market itself, it remain quite weak. So we just have to be again very guarded with our long or short positions. Trade the very obvious stock that give us better odds.